to talk to you about the scouting process here. I'm not necessarily talking just about the scouting process in the draft or for rookies. That's part of it. But also when you're looking at your running back room, when Bobby goes and when Miles Sanders is leaving the organization and you know you need to strengthen, let's say, you know, maybe not like directly replace. What's the scouting process when you're looking at guys like Rashard Penny, guys like Swift, who have huge upside, like crazy upside when they're fit and healthy, versus the current guys you have in the locker room with Kenny G, playoff Kenny, as we called him, as when he was going through the playoffs, I think a phrase that Mick coined, and the rookies that perhaps I'm sure we did look at a few rookies in the draft, and but what's the process you're going through when you're looking for these guys, when you're trying to build that room? Because there was a quote I think you made last year around durability, and that was, you know, if you have really one good back, chances are you're not going to finish with really one good back. So you need depth. It's extremely important, backs and also the O-line, which is really relevant now considering the room we have, right? Mm-hmm. It's a very long-winded question. I apologize. But what's your process when you're looking at rebuilding that running back room and you're scouting all these individuals?
You know, it's really kind of a two-part. You've got your free agents, right? Those are your guys that are in the NFL that either their contracts are up, or they're unrestricted or restricted free agents, those type of things. So you've got kind of your current NFL players to evaluate as well. So you go through that, there's going to be guys that are still under contract, so you don't waste any time with those. And you really kind of look at that. In that group could really be guys in your own room as well. So you may have a player that's becoming a free agent, aka Boston Scott. You know, he was up. He was a free agent this year. We were fortunate enough to sign him back. But so you have that piece of it. And then you have the draft, obviously. And you've got these college players. Now, none of them have played in the NFL. So it's really kind of how do you rate this player as a little bit more of a projection as opposed to, well, I can turn on this guy's last game in the NFL, and this is what he looks like playing in the NFL. So it's really a little bit of you've got a projection. And then with those other guys, really, you could be a projection too. I think there's a big piece of the backs that we have in our room that's a little bit of a projection when you look at the new additions that we added from free agency in Rashard Penny and DeAndre Swift. So a couple of things, it's kind of twofold. And you're always looking in our scouting department, personnel, they're always keeping their eye out. This guy's coming up. And you really, at the end of the day, try to build the room. And I talked about this before. You know, I'm a firm believer that there's certain skills that your room as a running back room has to have, right? There has to be a short yardage runner. There has to be a third down protector. There has to be a third down route runner. There has to be a first and second down runner, right? Just some basic things that need. Now, you can get a combination of that through multiple players. Some, and this is just my personal opinion. The days of an every down back don't exist. That's just my personal. There's not a guy. The league is too fast. It's too physical, and the season is too long for one person in the running back position to carry the load of everything. To be the first and second down runner, be the protector when they're bringing blitzes, running routes on the third down.
You look at C-Mac, right? Christian McCaffrey, like probably the best example of what that is. But the injuries that have curtailed. The prime of his career in the middle. That's what you're alluding to here, right?
I'd agree. I mean, it's just, and you mentioned what I said, durability. It's that piece. It's like, there's a little bit of a factor. We're saying, oh, well, he's not real durable. Well, maybe he hasn't been used correctly either. So it's, well, how do you maximize players? Well, ask them to do what they do best, right? Don't ask them to do what they're not very good at. And it's okay. Well, how do you find that happy medium? And obviously in a running back room, well, it's like, okay, well, let's put these guys in certain roles. If they can play multiple roles, great. But what's the thing they do the best? Yeah. And hopefully your room matches up that you have a guy that does all of those skill sets that you need the best. Maybe one guy does two of them and another guy does one of them, however. Okay. I really think last year, just our backfield in our room, when you had Boston Scott, and you had Kenny Gainwell, and you had Miles Sanders, you saw three of those guys in all different situations come on and help us win games. you know. And I think if you don't have those, if you didn't have Kenny and you didn't have Boston, well, Miles doesn't play the amount of games he did. Miles had the most durable year he had in his career. Didn't miss a game, played in all of them, rushed for 1,200 yards, in the Pro Bowl, all that stuff, right? And it's what he needed to do and at that point. But it's, I don't know if he does that if he doesn't have Kenny Gainwell taking third down reps and that, and Boston Scott being able to come in and give him a breather. So it's tough. And that's what I'm always looking for in a room is like, do I have the pieces to accomplish the things that I need? And I firmly believe you look at Rashad Penny, right? And you look at what he's done with him. When you take just the games that he's played, healthy, just take that. Disregard the other stuff, obviously. But you take those games and you look at his average per carry. You look at his yards and his touchdown. Like, he's an explosive player. I remember him when he came out of college. A really good friend of mine was a quarterback coach at San Diego State. So I knew of Rashad before that. I went to his pro day, met with him, all that stuff. He was returning kickoffs for touchdowns in college, right? So potential. DeAndre Swift.
Were you a big part of that, Jamal? I'm just touching on that because you've just talked about knowing him at college, knowing people there at his pro day. When you realized Penny was in the market and for a very decent deal, which it turned out to be for someone who you mentioned averages over 6 yards per carry when he's fit and healthy and runs the ball and incredible when he's healthy. Did you have a part in that? Because I know.
You do, and it's everybody, but it's not just one person. I mean, one person.
No, of course.
Obviously, Howie has the final say with guys, but you know, I'm going to evaluate his tape. Offensive coordinator is going to evaluate the tape. You know, our head coach is going to evaluate the tape. The scout in that area is going to evaluate the tape. So you're going to have multiple evaluations on this guy, and everybody's going to say, okay, this is what I think. This is what I think. This is what I think. And Howie at the end of the day, okay, this is, I'm taking all this information. And okay, this is what I think. And it's,
do you ever bang down the door? You're like, Howie, we really need to get this guy.
I mean, that's if there's a player that you truly want, I mean, you stand on the table for, you firmly believe that player can help you, then you do that, right? Nice. And it's both ways. If you firmly believe this is not the guy, then you have to do that. And that's staying true. And that's how, as an organization, you can work on making sure you're getting really good players and talent. And it's the same free agency and the draft. The draft is obviously a little bit bigger process, but it goes in. I'm going to speak my piece on every running back that I'm asked to evaluate. The scout is going to speak his piece on every back, and you're going to have different minds.
What's that like, coach? Like, because you're giving such great insight in what it's like to be a positional coach, assistant head coach within a team when you're talking about drafting and scouting. Like, I have like zero experience, and I'm sure a lot of UK fans listening in will have way less experience of what that dynamic is like. Like, what's the dynamic like between, you don't need to talk about people or anything like that, but just in general, like scouting, people coming to you with scouting reports versus what you know and what you've seen in your experience. Like, do you find like, is there often loggerheads? Is there a lot of agreement? Like, is it a bit of both? Like, what's that dynamic like?
You talk about the gamut of different things, because a certain guy may fall in love with a guy that he's watched and all that, but maybe he hasn't watched the same guys that you've watched, and you've watched a different tier. And in my group of guys, this guy's in rack and stack very high, but in his group, he didn't. So for me, it's you have to take everything that you know. So my experience as a running back coach, my evaluation, that there's certain things that when you go through and you watch, you're like, okay, yeah, I remember he's similar to so-and-so. That was a successful trait for him. And you look at it that way. And that's what I'll go through. I'm going to go through and watch a running back, every one of his carries that he's had, every one of his pass blocking attempts that he had, every one of his receptions are targets that he had. And I'm going to look and evaluate that. And I'm going to look at those three areas of his play. Because to me, as a back, it's running, it's protecting, it's catching. Those are the three things that we have to be good at. So what type of runner you are. The runner piece, they should be the, I mean, if I'm in the NFL and I'm evaluating a guy that's a running back, he better be able to run a football. Like, that to me should be like, check. Now, degreeing level of, okay, this guy's phenomenal, this guy's good, this guy's okay, those type of things. But that piece should be good. The protection piece, and I think I even mentioned this last, the protection piece, that's the toughest for a college guy. It's a different system. They aren't one-on-one pass protecting, picking up linebacker blitzes as often as you'll get in the NFL. And even in the NFL, it's a small number. So a limited number of clips. So it's a want to, can he and will he? I always say, is he a willing combatant? If he's going to throw his face in there and try, I can work with that. I can develop the talent on that. If he's shying away from it, and he, hey, you see him grimace a little bit.
I love a running back putting just getting the chip in there. It's
yeah, it's you gotta, there's some critical factors there that you kind of look at. So like a toughness piece, that's going to be the first thing that turns me off on a player. And that's the way, hey, oh, he ducked out of bounds. Oh, he avoided contact. Oh, because if he's making business decisions in college, hey, he ain't got time for
that. What's he going to do in the NFL?
Yeah. So it's, yeah. But it's different. Think about it. We could all watch a highlight tape or watch a full game of a player. And we may all walk away with differences. Oh, well, I like this and I like that. And I'm like, what are you talking about? I don't know. And it's, but it is, it's different. And it's, at the end of the day, it's our opinion. Like it's like this is what I see, and the tape can tell different people different things, but it's still based on the tape. So it's a crazy problem. Here's the thing: if it was a science, like everybody be good at it. I mean, it'd be easy to just okay, let me punch this into our equation. Okay, yeah, he's a good player. Let's draft him. It doesn't work that way. We're dealing with people. We're dealing with emotion. We're dealing with a lot of different things that determine whether a player is good or not. I mean, players that start out maybe not great end up being even better, you know, not to bring it up, but Jason Kelce early in his career probably wasn't thought very highly of. Well, fast forward 6 years now, he's always been playing
greatest center of all time.
He's like, yeah, he's a first ballot Hall of Famer, right? But yeah. It's how many people saw that from that, and it's tough. And the process, I wish you would sit here and say, okay, this is what we do. This is what we do. It's different. Every class that comes out from the running back position is different.
Well, you're never going to improve if you don't, right? If you know, exactly. I look at what I do in my job, right? And, you know, and if I went about like my bids to win contracts every week the same way as I did the last one, then I would stagnate after a few. You know, I'll probably send the listeners to sleep even talking about what I do. But
that's the same thing with us. You watch. Yeah. I'm going to miss. Like there, I may have an opinion. Like I don't see it. And then 3 years down the road, this guy's
Derrick Henry.
Like, yeah, he's that. Well, what was it? What would I? And I'll go back. What was it that I didn't? Like, there was something. Something stuck out to me. It was like, oh, this. And then you come and find out, well, no, his coaches were telling him not to do it. You know, there's just different things. So, like, okay, let me make sure the next time I evaluate a guy that has something like this, let me dig a little bit deeper here. Let me make sure. And then vice versa. A guy that I was high on that nobody else liked, and then he's balling. Then I'm like, yeah, see, I told you. but that's the piece, too. It's like, okay, well, look, this guy played out right. So and there's the injury piece that you never can account for. But it's for me, it's always about, do I have the skill sets in my room that are required on Sundays? Can, from the guys that I have active on the sideline, can we get accomplished everything we need to get accomplished at different degrees? I want them all to be here, but man goes down. Yeah, this guy can step into that role. It may be a step below that, but we can still kind of function and work, and he can still help us and do some things. So it's, to me, it's all about how do you build a position group, and each position group has different needs. Every position coach is going to have critical factors that they're looking for in all their players, and kind of rack and stack that and come up with what they feel is okay. Yeah, this is a guy that I'd like to see. This is a guy that can help us. Let's try and draft him. Where? Oh, let's figure out where we at, what picture we are. Is he there? Those are the, so it's, it's
for that. Banging down Howie's door to get Bijan Robinson in at pick 9 out of 10.
Well, that's exactly what you're saying. That's why I have such respect for Howie with what he does, because at the end of the day, he's taking all that information from his scouting department, from the coaching department, from analytics, everything, and he's putting that together and coming up with his basic plan with help from everyone of like, this is how we're going to do this.
Genius.
And he's a wizard.